Finder of Lost Loves. Brought to you by Minty Tasting Antiseptic Scope with T25. It leaves your breath minty, not medicine-y.
Mom, why do we feed rats?
I'm therefore enclosing a copy of said document for your file. Read it at your leisure, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to give me a call at my office.
I look forward to your earliest response. Sincerely, Judge Alexander Hale. Okay, Carol, that's the last one.
Excuse me, Judge Hale.
Alex, thank you for coming.
Oh, none at all. It's a pleasure.
Alex. Alex. He left us in the car.
Thank you, sweetheart. Cary Maxwell, my fiancée, Gail Ames.
Hello.
Oh, how do you do?
Nice to meet you. I'm sorry to interrupt, but he was up half the night working on this. I told him if it wore a dress and lipstick, I'd be jealous. Well, hi. Nice meeting you.
Mm. Same here. She's charming.
I've never known anyone to compare with her.
And yet my notes say you're looking for a lost love.
I am, Cary. Hers.
But I thought you and Gail were engaged.
We are. You saw her.
She's young, pretty. And she looked very much in love.
More grateful. When I first met Gail, she just arrived in Los Angeles. Practically nothing. I gave her a hand, got her a job, helped her get her life together.
No woman who looks like Gail marries anyone out of gratitude.
She might, if she lost the man she really loved. Man whose name, even now, she cries out in her sleep.
Have you talked to her about him?
I've tried, but she's evasive. I've written down the little I know about him. It seems they were together until about 4 years ago, then apparently something happened that forced them apart. From what I gather, she hasn't seen him since then.
And you've said nothing to her about this, sir?
If you find him, if he still cares for her, then I'll tell her. Her happiness means everything to me.
Even if it costs you your own?
Yes.
I'm Jim
Chasen. I tried to reach you all day yesterday. Mr. Maxwell got an emergency call and had to cancel today's appointment. We're terribly sorry.
Do you think it might be possible to reschedule me for the next day or two? I'm visiting from out of town.
Oh, well, why don't you make yourself comfortable while I try and find you another appointment?
Thank you.
Rita, did the mail come yet? Oh, excuse me.
Daisy?
Jim? Jim Chasen. Oh, boy, how are you? Oh.
I take it you two know each other.
I've never seen her before in my entire life.
We're old friends.
Well, you work here?
Is that so strange?
Well, this whole thing is strange.
Well, when did you get back to the States?
2 months ago.
Well, he didn't develop an English accent.
Nor a passion for cricket, which meant that I could teach Shakespeare with no distractions. You look more beautiful than ever.
Oh, Jim and I went to college together. He majored in charm.
Cary can see you tomorrow afternoon at 4, if that's good for you, Jim.
Well, that's wonderful. Daisy, does that mean that we can catch up between now and then?
Oh, I'd love to, if I've got time. Rita, when's my next appointment?
Oh, you have a lunch today, in fact. And you better get moving.
Well, who's it with?
A Mr. Jim Chasen.
Oh.
There you are. Mrs. Hargrove got a lead on that dude the judge wants to find. Here you go. Now, get this. He's vice president of a real estate company in Las Vegas. Now, the way I figured is, now, we take your jet. Now, with me driving, we could get there and back by tonight.
Excuse me, Lyman. What do you mean, we?
So, how do you plan on getting around Vegas without me?
Ever heard of taking a cab?
Sure, I took a cab once. Well, I got caught, though.
After my sister died, I'd look at Cary and think, he's probably the only person that misses Kate more than I do. So to ease the pain, he started Maxwell Limited.
Thank you. And offered you a job.
Yeah, he said he needed help, but I think he was just giving me shelter.
Can he really find anyone?
Well, he's rarely stumped. Who is it you're looking for? If you don't discuss it, that's okay.
No, I don't mind if you don't mind. Mm. I first met Amanda, well, shortly after you told me to get lost.
I did not tell you to get lost. I just said I wasn't ready.
Anyway, so she's terrific. She's warm and she's alive. I fell for her because she's a lot like you.
Thank you.
And I'd learned my lesson, or rather, your lesson. I didn't push Amanda for a commitment. I just let the relationship build.
What happened?
It ended. She got homesick and left London. She just didn't seem to be able to adapt. Too much rain, too much starchy food. Too many people saying, blimey.
Have you heard from her?
She sent me a postcard from Miami, but she's not listed in the phone book down there. I just want her to know that I'm back in the States and that I'm hers if she wants me. Would you find her for me, Daisy?
Cary will. You'll like him. He's very understanding, easy to talk to.
So are you.
I just don't think it's a good idea to work professionally with someone you're close to.
We're close to. We're just good friends now.
Even so.
You don't think I'm over you?
No, I'm sure you are.
Then what are you afraid of?
My boss's reaction when I tell him I'm taking this case.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mr. Maxwell, I'm sorry to keep you waiting. My name is Steve Bates. Can I help you?
Well, you can if you're the same Steve Bates who used to know Gail Ames.
Gail Ames?
Mm-hmm.
Did she send you?
Gail doesn't know anything about this. I was asked to find you by Judge Alex Hale, Gail's fiancé.
She told him about us?
Actually, she's told him very little. That's why he's afraid Gail's still in love with you. And he thought if you still felt the same way about her, then you two belong together.
I don't understand. You mean he would just step aside?
He loves Gail very much.
I don't know what to say.
I noticed this photograph on your desk. Yours?
For all of 10 months. Her name is Nicole.
You and your wife must be very proud. Well, I guess since you're married...
Married? Mr. Maxwell, I'm not married. At least not anymore.
You're divorced?
Yeah. Funny thing is, my wife left claiming that I had never really gotten over Gail. Truth is, she was right. I want to see her, Mr. Maxwell.
Well, you realize Gail may not feel the same way.
If she doesn't, I'll understand. But regardless... It's So if you'll give this to her?
Very well. Goodbye, Mr. Bates.
Goodbye, and thank you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, your coming here today might be the best thing that's happened to me in a very long time. This Judge Hale must be quite a guy.
Yes, he is.
So busy with this judge. Why don't you let me take that client you had to cancel today?
Oh, that's very thoughtful of you, Daisy. What kind of case is it?
Just a guy who's in love with a girl who's disappeared.
This isn't the fellow that Rita was talking about, is it?
Who is that?
Well, a very handsome, charming professor of English whom you dated when you were both in college.
So what?
So, you think that's a good idea?
Oh, I don't think it's a bad idea. I mean, well, Jim is... Well, I know him. I understand him. He's easy to be with.
Are you sure there are no lingering feelings?
Cary, he's looking for the woman he wants to marry. I'd say that makes it pretty clear where he's coming from.
Where are you coming from?
I'm the one who wanted to break up.
That was then. This is now.
What are you getting at?
Just that I think that our interest in our client should be professional.
And does that mean it has to be impersonal?
No, of course not.
Look, Jim and I are going to Miami tomorrow, and we are going to find his girlfriend, right?
Daisy, I wouldn't do that.
What are you so worried about?
If you recall, I had become very involved with a client. Remember Sarah Nevins?
She was a client. Jim is a friend.
That's all the more reason why you shouldn't get involved in this case.
Don't you have any faith in me?
I just want you to learn from my mistakes.
Yeah, and I'd like room to make my own.
Daisy, you don't know what you're doing.
Yes, I do. And for the first time in my life, I am not listening to you. Amanda's workplace down at the Cary Tennis Club. But everyone who could give me any information was out to lunch.
You're speaking literally, I hope.
Salads, not insanity.
Can I come along when you go to these places?
Sorry. I want to make sure that everyone that we're trying to find wants to see the person who's trying to find them.
And you don't believe that she's crazy about me, do you?
Not that there's any apparent reason why she should be.
A few years ago, I would have tossed you in the pool for a remark like that.
Have you developed some restraint in your old age?
Who are you calling on?
Older.
Do you remember me as being immature?
I remember us as being young.
Unrealistic. Uncompromising.
You sure did have fun.
How did you manage to avoid marriage?
I think we should keep our conversation professional.
Professional? Okay, professional. I thought you'd be married by now, but I knew you'd be a career woman. After all, you got accepted by every law school you applied to.
You remember that?
Oh, Daisy, I remember your soap and your favorite color and your lucky number and exactly how long you like to soak in a hot bath.
I guess you have a pretty good memory.
Actually, I don't.
I better go find Amanda.
I hope you do. There's been a real emptiness in my life since she left.
With any luck, you'll soon be back together.
If you can do that, Daisy, it won't be luck. It'll be you.
Exactly what I was afraid of.
I'm sorry, Alex. It's the first time I've wished that the person I was looking for hadn't wanted to be found. But he did. So
And now I'm going to lose her.
No, you don't know that. She may not even want to see him. In fact, she may be angry that you even doubted her love.
If only I could believe that.
Well, why don't you try believing Gail instead? After all, that's why you did this, right? For Gail? Why not let her decide?
Would you be there when I talk to her?
If you wish.
I wish. I wish I'd listened to you, never started this.
Oh, but now that you have, the sooner it's ended, the better.
I just think she's gonna leave me.
And I just think your insecurity is getting the best of you.
Oh, come on, Cary, you admitted yourself. He's young, good-looking. What woman wouldn't want a guy like him?
One who loves a guy like you.
Daisy Lloyd from Maxwell Limited in California. We find people for other people.
Have I just been found?
Jim Chasen is looking for you. He's living in the States again.
He told me that would never happen.
Well, he's ready to settle down now.
Jim Chasen wants to get married?
Are you surprised?
If you knew Jim like I know Jim, you'd be shocked too.
What do you mean?
I thought he didn't believe in marriage. Well, maybe he's finally gotten that girl out of his system.
I don't understand.
Oh, he was burned in a relationship. He was ready, the girl wasn't. He never recovered. And not wanting that to happen again, he's never been able to commit. Finally, I couldn't take it anymore, so I just took off.
Well, he's talking commitment now.
Why isn't he here?
Well, I wanted to make sure that you wanted to see him.
You doubted that I'd want this man? A guy like Jim Chasen comes along once in a lifetime.
Well, why don't you give me your number and I'll give it to Jim.
So glad you found me.
I'm sure he will be too. Are you a friend of his?
Yeah, I guess you could say that. Oh, well, in that case, why don't the two of you come over for dinner tonight? Say around 7? Here, I'll give you my address. We'll have a celebration.
I don't think so.
Well, bring a date if you'd like. Are you here by yourself?
Yeah.
Okay. In that case, your attendance is not only welcome, it's required.
Don't you want to spend some time alone with him?
From what you're saying, I'll have the rest of my life for that.
I don't understand. Why would you ask Mr. Maxwell to find Steve Bates?
Because I love you, Gail. You've given me so much joy, so much happiness. I wanted to do the same for you.
Mr. Maxwell, what's he talking about?
Well, Alex asked me to find Steve because he felt you might still be in love with him and wanted you to have the chance to choose between them.
Alex. I made my choice the moment we met. I chose you. Why couldn't you trust that? Why can't you just leave well enough alone?
Because well enough isn't good enough, Gail. Not for you. You deserve more out of marriage than some old gray-haired character.
Don't you see? That old gray-haired character is what I want.
Well, if that's the case, Gail, there's no law that says that you have to see Steve.
Although, to be fair, he does want to see you.
Steve said that?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, he wanted me to give you this.
You do have to see him, don't you?
You become a tennis pro?
Well, my father wanted an athlete, and my mother said I look good in white.
Oh, well.
You know, my father would have loved it if I'd been more athletic. My father would have loved it if I'd been a boy.
I can think of a lot of people who are mighty glad you're not.
It was very nice to meet you, Amanda. Especially after all the wonderful things Jim said about you.
Well, exaggerating is one of the things he does best.
No, the superlatives were well deserved. He's very fortunate to have you.
Well, having him's not so bad either.
Well, I've got to get going. But I want to thank you for a lovely evening, and I hope you two will be very happy.
Thanks, Daisy.
Thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome. Bye.
Now be a gentleman and walk Daisy to her car.
A gentleman, huh?
Oh, come on, you can fake it. Here.
There we go.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.
She really is terrific, Jimmy.
Yes, she is. When do you go back to Los Angeles?
Tomorrow morning, if I can get on a flight.
I still think about you more than I should.
Well, I think the world of you two.
When I picked you up at your office, your boss looked at me in a funny way.
Well, his face sometimes does that.
He didn't want you to take this case, did he?
No. No, he didn't.
And you didn't listen to him?
Or my best instincts.
I guess this is it. Well, Gail should be here any minute. Ever since you called and said she'd see me, every second it seemed like a lifetime. Well, I guess I'll wait inside. I really appreciate all your help, Mr. Maxwell.
Oh, not at all. It's Alex Hale you should be thanking.
Well, if things work out, I'll have a lot to thank him for. Thanks again.
I'm here.
It's good to see you too, baby.
I'm not your baby anymore, Steve.
Oh, that's right. You're marrying a judge. Very respectable judge. Very wealthy judge.
What do you want?
Just a little share of the profits, that's all. For old times' sake. You do remember old times, don't you?
Blackmail.
No, I prefer to call it charity. Save a man's good reputation from a scandal that just might ruin his career. So what do you say?
Steve, please, I love him.
I thought you'd say that.
Before you left. Is there a problem?
No, I feel better about things now than I have in a long time. I'll never be able to thank you enough for what you did in bringing him to me, Daisy.
Well, you two are quite a couple.
Yes. We were.
What do you mean?
After you left, we started to talk marriage again, and he was noncommittal.
Oh, Amanda, marriage makes a lot of people nervous.
When I left London, I thought Jim just needed time to grow up. But now I see it's not something lacking in him or in me that's keeping us apart.
I don't understand.
It's the dream he's never given up. That girl. So it's over. But I'm glad, Daisy. Maybe now I can finally put him behind me.
How did Jim react?
I didn't tell him.
When are you going to?
I'm not. You are.
Amanda, I think this is something that should come from you. Why should I be the one to tell him that the relationship is over?
Because his love for you is why we never had a chance.
I'm sorry to call you, Cary, but I really didn't know what else to do.
Oh, I'm glad you did.
When I phoned Gail last night and she said she didn't want to talk, I thought, okay, I'm pushing. Back off.
And now she's refusing to see you?
When I dropped by her apartment this morning, she wouldn't even open the door. I could tell from the sound of her voice she'd been crying.
Maybe Gail just needs some time alone to think things through.
I'm willing to give her all the time she needs, but I'm worried.
What do you mean?
It isn't like her, withdrawing like this. I mean, Gail's always been so open, so willing to discuss everything. I can't help thinking this means she's decided to go with him and can't face telling me.
What would you like me to do?
Go to her. Tell her whatever she's decided to do. I'll understand. If only she'll talk to me.
Well, she may refuse to see me, too, but I'll certainly try.
Don't let her leave my life without a word.
How could she possibly have found out?
I don't know. We should have told her.
Some reference to the past. The way we look at each other.
I think we just underestimated her insight and Carrie's wisdom.
We could make it work this time. I never meant to hurt her.
If Cary had been on this case, it never would have happened.
Daisy, we can't blame ourselves. And I can't blame her for wanting out.
What do you mean?
I didn't want this to happen. And I bet you didn't either. But, oh, Daisy, these last few days have been so charged.
You know, maybe you could try talking to Amanda.
You're the one I should talk to. And for once, you should listen to me.
Jim, don't.
Daisy. It was obvious to her. Why isn't it obvious to you? I came to Maxwell Limited to find a lost love. And I found her. She just wasn't the one I thought I was looking for.
You're saying this is fate?
I'm saying this is love.
Alex asked me to come. He's very worried about you, Gail.
Please, tell him I'll be fine.
He'd rather hear that from you.
Yeah, well, believe me, it's better this way.
Better? Or easier?
You think it's easy, leaving a man like Alex Hale? You think it doesn't break my heart?
Well, tell him how you feel. Leave him something to remember besides the pain.
Just make matters worse.
Well, how much worse can things be than you're walking away without a word? He's a good man, Gail. He deserves more.
Don't you think I know that? God, why else would I be leaving?